हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम रोहन चौगले एंड टुडे अगेन वी आर हियर टू स्टडी दी लूप सिस्टम विच आर प्रेजेंट इन सी प्रोग्रामिंग. एज इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फॉर लूप. नाउ हियर इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द कंसेप्ट ऑफ व्हाइल लूप एंड डू व्हाइल लूप विथ एग्जाम्पल. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विथ व्हाइल लूप. सो एज आई सेड इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑल्सो that we have to follow some syntax while writing any program in C. So here is the syntax for while loop. So here while, what is, let's look at the syntax. This is a syntax for while loop. So while, in round bracket we have to write the condition, and after that in opening closing curly bracket we have to write the statements which we have to execute when the condition is true. So this is a simple syntax of while loop. So let's see how this while loop works with the help of flowchart. So this is a flowchart on the right side of the screen. So once your control enters into the while loop, so before entering into the while loop it checks the condition. So as I said, before enter into the while loop it checks the condition, that's why it is called as entry controlled loop. While loop and for loop are entry controlled loops, right? So here first when control comes to the while loop it checks the condition. So if your condition is true, then it comes inside the while loop and it executes the statement, okay, maybe single or multiple statements. It will execute the statements which you have written under the while loop, and after execution of that statement your control will again move towards the condition. Again it checks the condition. If condition is true, again it will come inside the while loop. It will execute all the statements written under the while loop and again it move towards the condition, and this process will go on continuing till your condition is true. And once the condition become false, your control will directly move outside the while loop and it will execute the statements which you have written after the while loop. So this is about simple syntax and flowchart of while loop. So let's discuss. Okay, so I have written the same over here. First condition is evaluated. If the condition is true, then the statement part is executed and then it checks the condition. If condition is false, then it comes out of the while loop. Okay, so same I have written there. So let's see one simple example. As in previous part we have taken one example that we have to print number from 1 to 5. Same example I am having over here. So here we have to print numbers from 1 to 5 with the help of while loop. So again the same, I include the header files stdio.h, then void main, so the bracket, curly bracket with the red and curly bracket opening curly bracket with the red color and closing curly bracket with the red color are the opening and closing curly brackets for the void main function. Okay, in that void main, in that opening closing curly bracket we have to write the program. So next, after writing the void main function, what I have done, I have simply written the statement int I. So what is that? This is called a declaration of function here. Sorry, not function. This is a declaration of variable. So here I have declared one variable I of type integer. Then next, as we have to move from 1 to 5, so we have to start from 1. So I have initialized value of I to the 1. Okay, if you want to print the number from 0 to 5, then you have to initialize value of I to the 0. But here in this case, as we have to print the numbers from 1 to 5, so I have assigned value of I is equals to 1. Next is our while loop. Okay, so while, let's simultaneously just check the program and table also. With the help of table I am trying to explain this program. So while I is less than 6, so here in this case initially value of I is 1. So 1, here condition, the first column gives the condition, second output, and third is the increment of I. Okay, accordingly I have written the columns. So first it will check the condition. Initially value of I is 1, so 1 is less than 6 here in the table. It says 1 is less than 6. Yes, 1 is less than 6. So your condition is true. Control will come inside the while loop, and in while loop simply I have printed the value of I. So here in this case value of I is 1, so output we get as 1. After that print statement we have increment I plus plus. Okay, increment operator. Okay, so as we have to increase value from 1 to pi, or we have to travel from 1 to pi, so we have to increase the value of I. So here I use I plus plus. So once this statement will get executed, the value of I becomes 2. Now value of I is 2. Then after the execution of this I plus plus, again our control, as I shown over here, after execution of all the statements, control will move towards the condition. So again it will check the condition. Okay, here I value of I is 2, so 2 is less than 6. Yes, 2 is less than 6. Again control will come inside the, as condition is true, control will come inside the while loop. It will print the value of I, that is 2, and after that it will go for increment statement. It will increase the value of I by 1, so I becomes 3. Again the same process will go on repeating. I becomes 3, 3 is less than 6. Yes, it is less than 6, so it will print value of 3. It will increase the value I by 1, that is it becomes 4. Then 4 is less than 6, condition is true, it will print the value of I, that is 4. Then it will increase the value of I, so I become 5. Then again it will check the condition, 5 is less than 6. Yes, it is less than 6, so control will come inside while loop. It will print the value of I, that is 5, and after printing the value of I, that is 5, it will increase the value of I by 1, so I become 6. So after that again it will check the condition, 6 is less than 6, no. So in this case your condition become false, and as your condition become false, your control will move outside the while loop. So it will not enter into the while loop. So as condition is false, it simply move outside the while loop, and after while loop we have written nothing, so it will not execute any statement. It will simply end the program. So once your program will get executed, what output we will get? We get output 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. As we have already discussed this, how your while loop or your this program will execute it with the help of table. So I hope you understand how this while loop works. So it is exactly, the working is similar to that of for loop, because we have initialization, then condition, again we have increment operator, again we have one statement under the while loop. So same, but the statements we have written on different places. So I hope you understand this concept of while loop. Now let's discuss the concept of do while loop. Okay, so here is the syntax for do while loop. So let's go through the syntax. So first, at this do while loop, first we have to write the do, again it is a keyword, then opening curly bracket, and in opening and closing curly bracket we have to write the statements that we have to execute repeatedly when condition is true. So after writing the statements, we have to write the while condition, while, and in bracket we have to write the condition. Remember that in do while loop, after the while we have to write the semicolon, but in case of while we have not written any semicolon after this while and condition, but in case of do while loop we have to write the semicolon after the while condition. Let's see how this do while loop executes. So once your control comes to the do while loop, it directly enters into the while loop. It directly enters into the while loop. It executes all the statements you have written under the do while loop. Sorry, once your control comes to the do while loop, it directly enters into do while loop. It executes all the statements you have written under the do while loop. Okay, after execution of all the statements, what it will do? It will simply check the condition. And after checking the condition, if your condition is true, then your control will come inside the do while loop. Again it will execute all the statements written inside the do while loop, and after that it move towards the condition block, condition again. So again, if condition is true, again the same process will go on repeating. Once your condition become false, then only your control will come outside the do while loop. So here remember that, as I said, when your control come inside the do while loop, it directly enters into that do while loop without checking the condition. And here in this case, when condition is checked while exiting from the loop, okay, while exiting from the loop, after the execution of all the statements under the do while loop, when exiting from the do while loop, your condition will get checked, right? So while exiting, here in this case, while exiting, your condition will get checked. That's why this do while loop is called as exit controlled loop. And for and while loop are entry controlled loop, whereas do while is exit controlled loop. I hope you understand the syntax and the flowchart for do while loop. So let's see, a do while loop is similar to while loop, except the fact is that it execute at least one time. It doesn't matter, okay, it won't matter your condition is true or false, but at least once your do while loop will get executed, because your control will directly enters into the do while loop, and after execution of all the statement, then it checks the condition whether condition is true or false. Though your condition is false, but control first enter into the do while loop and then it checks the condition. So at least once your do while loop will get executed. So here in this case, as I said, first statement part is executed and then condition part is evaluated. If the condition is true, again the statement part is executed and again the condition part is evaluated. So first statement will get executed, then condition, if condition is true, again statement will get executed, and after that again it will check the condition. So this loop is continue till condition is true, and once your condition is false, your control will come outside the do while loop. So this is a simple explanation for do while loop. So let's see the same example using do while loop to print number from 1 to 5. So again here I have written the header files, then void main function, then I have declared one variable I of type integer, then I is equals to 1. As I said, we have traveled from 1 to 5, so I have initialized value of I to the 1. So next, do while loop. So let's see do while loop with the help of tabular, with the help of table. So as I said, firstly, your control directly enters into the do while loop, and once it enters into do while loop, it simply print the value of I. So value of I is initially 1. So look at the table. So value of I is 1. So after that, the control enters into the do while loop, it will execute the print statement. It will print the value of I, that is 1. Then it will increase the value of I plus plus statement is there. So it increases the value of I by 1. So I becomes 2. Right? And after that, it checks the condition. So as I said, it increases the value of I by 1, so I becomes 2. So it will check the condition. 2 is less than 6. Yes, it is less than 6. So condition is true. So after, when condition is true, again control will enter into the statement part, right? So after execution of this condition, it will enter into the statement part. It will execute the statements you have written under the do while loop. So here value of I becomes 2, it will print the output as a 2. Then after that, it will go to the increment statement. It will increase the value of I by 1, so I becomes 3. Then it will, after that we have a condition, while condition, so it will check the condition. Sorry, I forgot, here I have written the I, so this is I. So just consider this as a I. So this is I. So after this, it will check the condition. 3 is less than 6. Yes, it is less than 6. So your control is come. Condition is true. Control will enter into the do while loop. It will execute all the statements written inside the do while loop. That is, it will print the value of I, that is 3. Then it will increase the value of I by 1. So I becomes 4. Then it will again check the condition. 4 is less than 6. Yes, it is less than 6. So it will enter into the do while loop, it will print the value of I, that is 4, then it will increase the value of I by 1, I become 5, and after that again it will check the condition, 5 is less than 6, yes it is less than 6, condition is true. Again it will jump inside the do while loop, it will execute the printf statement, it will print the value of I, that is 5, then it will execute the next statement, that is I++, it will increase the value of I by 1, I becomes 6. And after that, it will enter into the while condition. It will check the condition while 6 is less than 6. So 6 is less than 6? No. It is equal to 6. So your condition becomes false. So once the condition becomes false, your control will move outside the do while loop. It will not enter into do while loop. So while exiting from the loop, what output we get? We get simple 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is simple do while loop. Okay, as I explained in this program, your control directly enters into do while loop before checking the condition. That's why at least once your do while loop will get executed. Okay, so this is about the while and do while loop. So let's take a quick review. So this is a syntax for do while loop. In while loop, first we check the condition, and if condition is true, then statement will get executed, and if condition is false, your control will come outside the do while loop. Until the condition is true, your statement part will get executed continuously. Okay, so this is a program I have explained. Then next one is do while loop. First, in this case, first statement part will get executed, and after that it will check the condition. If condition is true, again it will execute the statement part. After the execution of statement part, it will check the condition. If condition is again true, this it will enter into the do while loop and it will execute the statements. So this process will go on continuing till your condition is true, and once the condition becomes false, your control will come outside the do while loop. Remember, in do while loop we have to write the semicolon after end of the do while condition, but in case of while loop we have not written any semicolon over here, but in do while loop we have to write semicolon. The next, remember that at least once your do while loop will get executed. Else part is same. Then I have explained the do while loop with the help of program. Okay, so I hope you understand this loops in C. That is for loop. We have studied for loop in previous lecture, and in this lecture we have studied while loop and do while loop. Okay, so while loop and for loop are entry control loop, whereas do while is exit control loop. Okay, so thank you.